Hello, sci-fi fans, and welcome to my channel. I'm Peg, and I just love reading anything having to do with otherworldly scenarios, any kind of speculative fiction. I'd like to welcome, I think I have quite a few new people, new subscribers, thanks to the kindness of some other booktubers who recommended me to their audience, and I appreciate that so much. And I assume that most of you are science fiction fans, but if you're not, please keep watching. Maybe I can convince you that science fiction books have, a lot of them have some literary merit. In fact, I think there's kind of a crossover more and more between literary novels and the genre novels. Anyway, so I'm going to be, one thing I'm really excited about, I'm going to be joining my first book challenge starting the 1st of September. It's a September sci-fi challenge, it's called, and it's sponsored by Becky Bookworm, a delightful young lady, and I will give you her link down below so you can see her and learn about the challenges in person. She even has a special sci-fi t-shirt that she wears for the announcement. I'm very jealous. I do plan to join this in a wholehearted way, but rather than just give you my selections in the five departments, I, as usual, have many, many selections. In fact, I'm looking at five piles of books I have to fit each category. So rather than bore you with all of those, I'm going to do one category a day for the rest of the week. I have 5 days till the start, and kind of maybe I can get some suggestions from you for the different categories. They really sound interesting, and I'm really looking forward to this. Okay, I will make my first video on the 2BR for that challenge later today, but I can't really think of two things at once, and I actually have a book that I just finished that I really want to talk about. This one is one weird book. It is called 3 Years with the Rat, and it's by Jay Hosking. I picked this up on my new science fiction shelf at the library, not knowing a thing about it. And it's one of the weirdest but good books, science fiction type books, I've ever read. I'm not going to go into great detail or a deep review, but let me just give you an idea. First of all, to get the real flavor of this, you have to know a little bit about the author. Now, this is this author's first book, though he's published some short stories, some prize-winning short stories, but let me tell you about him. Jay Hosking, he obtained his neuroscience PhD at the University of British Columbia by, get this, teaching rats how to gamble and studying the neurobiological basis of choice. I think that's probably in people, not rats. Anyway, I mean, would this lie to you? I don't think it would. I mean, I think this guy really did study rats for his PhD. Anyway, at the same time, he completed a creative MFA, and his short stories have appeared in and won competitions, been in several anthologies. He's currently back to science, and he researches decision-making and the human brain. I guess he got away from rats, but he seems to know a lot about rats, because guess who some of the main characters in this book are? There are rats, and not in a bad way, not in a bad way. You can tell he knows a lot about rats and their brain power, but let me set up the story for you a little bit. It's going to be one of those hard to describe. The theme of this is really, I think, about time and how we see time. Time is really not a rational linear progression like the clock says it is. And I think you realize that when you can look at the different times. An hour can seem like a minute in some cases if you're having a good time, or it can seem like a year if you're waiting for bad news or whatever. And it plays along with that idea of time in much of the story. First of all, I'll tell you the one experiment, scientific. The main characters, actual human characters, are two couples. One of the couples, both the man and the woman, are scientists and have this laboratory where they have rats and are and the way they're doing experiments with these rats is they have installed telemetry devices into the rats, into their brain, and they study through this the multidimensional time and subjectivity of time in this way. They somehow get the mice revved up and excited about different things, and they compare their external clock with the internal measurements of the rat's brain to see how time is going there. I'm not sure. Do you think he really studied this? I don't know, but it was sure interesting how they did it. Okay, it really wasn't all about rats, but there is a rat that becomes a friend to one of the main characters and kind of travels in his pocket a lot. And you kind of lose your, you know, bad feelings towards rats once you get to know them. You know, I thought to myself, why don't they use mice? Mice sound so much nicer than rats. But he does say at one of his points that rats themselves are much smarter than mice. Interesting tidbit. Okay, the story is so crazy and convoluted, I can't even begin to describe it. But it's these people running in and out. There's time machines type things involved. These four people are interacting. But the really cool thing this author does in his structure of the novel to match the feeling of time not being consistent is that he does not have linear progression in the story. There are 3 years involved, as it says, and he can be anywhere in those 3 years in each chapter. He does tell you what year he's in, but it's still really shocking when you, the next chapter, you're reading about somebody who died in the last chapter and now they're alive. And it's just really well done. And I have to say, the feeling of time even affected me while I was reading. I usually stop every 45 minutes or an hour and take a reading break when I'm reading. But I found myself just glued to this book, and time just passed by. I almost read the whole thing in one sitting. And by the time I finished, I didn't know what time it was or what year it was. It really affected me time-wise. So anyway, I just wanted to share this. This is due back at the library. I'm just about to head out and take it back and get some more for my book challenge, science fiction challenge piles. And I'll be letting you know later some of my choices for that. So hope you'll watch the science fiction challenge, and have a good day. Bye.